When we last left off with the Suicide Squad, Amanda Waller had gone ahead and faked her own death. But if you think back to the beginning of Suicide Squad Rebirth, one event happened that everyone questioned how it was even possible. The Suicide Squad had ended up freeing General Zod from the Phantom Zone, and he somehow was then defeated by the Suicide Squad. Well, you see, General Zod had not been powered up by the Yellow Sun yet. It was the only chance that the Suicide Squad had to defeat him, and then he was sealed away forever. Or so we thought, because as it turns out, Amanda Waller has kept him on ice until she found a way to put him on the Suicide Squad as one of her ultimate weapons. Welcome to the Complete Story Series, where I take trade paperbacks in single issues and I break them down into digestible bites to help you understand. Then I read them dramatically back to you. All alterations to the panels, text, and images are to prevent copyright problems, and all art is owned by its respective companies. Now, let's go find out how wrong this is going to go. In our last video, Amanda Waller staged her own death with the help of Deadshot and Enchantress to bring down Rustrum. While everyone thought Deadshot had defected to Rustrum's side, Amanda came back at the last minute, giving Deadshot the chance to prove whose side he's really on. But now, having control of Task Force X once again and having whatever tools that she may need to protect the United States, Amanda went to go see Lex Luthor regarding her new, pet project. As Amanda sits in Lex's office, Lex says that for Amanda Waller to come in to meet him, it's rather stimulating. Amanda tells him that he doesn't have to do the whole charming thing with her. She's only here on government business. Lex then slides a small gift box across the table, saying, "This is a small gift from LexCorp, so why is it that you're here?" Amanda says that she doesn't want his little corporate schmooze box, and Lex takes it back, stating, "Well, that's a shame. I picked it out myself." But while the two of them talk on the upper levels of LexCorp, on the lower levels, something else is starting to happen. As Task Force X steps through a portal, Enchantress shouts, "Yes! The blood portal or teleportation has torn their mortal securities asunder!" Boomerang says, "Right, that's nice." And as he flails his nub, he shouts, "I seem to be missing my entire arm! Why is it always me? First a Martian blows me up from the shins, and now this." As Rick tells him to shut up, the team can hear gunfire coming in their direction. Around the corner, LexCorp's security guards shout that they have a metahuman incursion in the lower vault. Inform Mr. Luthor and activate the alarms. Deadshot tells him that he's sorry, but he's got some bad news. Enchantress, put up a magical spell that stops all transmissions, so no one is setting off an alarm. A short while later, Enchantress returns with a giant monstrous arm, stating that she has returned with the Australian's lost arm from the blood portal. Boomerang looks at the arm, stating, "That's not mine!" And Enchantress asks, "Are you sure?" And Boomerang tells her, "Yeah, I'm pretty sure that one's not mine." Harley whispers, "Just think about all of the angles here. Just imagine how far you could throw a boomerang with that thing." Boomerang stops for a moment and says, "Actually, you might be right." Harley asks what's wrong. It's not like him to totally agree on something. A worried look comes over Boomerang, and after a moment of silence, he says, "I did a bad thing." Before he could go on, though, a bolt of electricity shoots through the group, and a robot walks out shouting, "No living beings are authorized in this area." Enchantress says that the robot detects the living. She has a solution for that. A green flash covers the group, and everyone starts to get up when the robot says, "Threat eliminated. Security LexBot shutting down." Boomerang asks, "What the hell?" And Enchantress says that she had to convince the building that they had successfully killed them. She made them all undead! Deadshot takes out his gun and pushes it in Enchantress's face, shouting, "That was not the plan!" And she says, "You are Deadshot, are you not? You of all people wish for death so often. But I can return life to your mortal shells once our objective has been obtained, if I so choose." As the group presses on, Boomerang says, "You know what I could really do now? I could throw precisely half the amount of boomerangs!" And Tantra shouts, "Fine! I shall return!" And she disappears in a puff of smoke. As she does, the canisters around everyone begin to hiss as they open. And Deadshot asks, "What is that? I thought this was supposed to be Lex's personal vault." And Rick looks around, telling him, "Yeah. Intel suggested that this is where he kept his experiments." A group of bizarro supermen jump out screaming, "Intruder, am welcome!" Everyone quickly starts to fight back against the supermen, and then Deadshot sees a group of canisters looking like they're going to explode, and he shoots them. But back upstairs, Amanda continues to play her part when suddenly the room turns red and the warning, "Vault breach," rings through the air. Amanda sighs, "Imbeciles." And Lex puts on his Superman armor, telling Amanda, "Well played." Seconds later, he slams down into the middle of the Suicide Squad, telling them, "That will be enough." And Harley, taking the chance, bites Lex on the head. A few moments later, Enchantress teleports Amanda down there and she tells Enchantress to go ahead and tell Lex what they did. Enchantress says that when they arrived, she infected the home computer with a demonic virus, one that is now within his entire network. Amanda goes on stating that unless she is given what she came for, she will release all of his information. Lex pulls out the small box from before, the one that he already tried to give her, and he tells her that he tried to give it to her earlier. He opens it showing kryptonite. Later, back at Belrive, Amanda tells the doctors to do it. Insert the kryptonite brain bomb into General Zod. A few days later, as the team is released back over Victoria Falls in Zimbabwe, Zod screams, "Kneel before Zod!" Harley says that she's got to admire a man who enjoys his work, and Deadshot adds, "We are going to die." Harcourt watches over and says that she doesn't see Boomerang in the group. Why is he not active? And Amanda tells her that he's on another mission. And no, she was not briefed on it. Zod rips ahead of everyone, and Amanda tells everyone to hurry up and follow Zod. Harley says that she's not so sure. The last time that they faced the Annihilation Brigade, they had that guy Tung Gunsta, who nearly burnt off her pretty little ponytails, so it's probably good that Zod goes first. Up ahead, Tung Gunsta blasts Zod with the power of 1,000 Soviet space rockets, shouting, "No one will stand the power of Tung Gunsta." Zod walks through the blast, grabbing onto Tungusta's helmet, telling him, "Death is possible! Zod will invent ways for that!" But before he can fully break the glass, the Cosmonaut bashes into Zod with his hammer-shaped head, shouting, "Nuts! Tankograd yells yes! Cosmonaut speaks the truth! Well said, friend!" As Tankograd unloads his guns, Tungusta shouts that his energies have been released, he's going to explode! Back over at another part of Belrive, a worker asks Harcourt if there's anything that they can help with. Normally she doesn't come down here. Harcourt takes out a gun and fires 4 shots into the workers, telling them, "No, not anymore." As she runs in, she starts to work at the computer, saying that she can get the frequencies to Zod's bomb brain. Then he could be a weapon for their cause. Harcourt then reports to Director Carla. And she tells them that they need to hurry up with their plans. The people must rise again. But after one last press of the buttons, the Belrive self-destruct countdown begins. Back in Zimbabwe, Deadshot continues on, and after blowing the doors out, him and Harley step into a giant prison. One of the prisoners says that they've been experimented on. They put explosives into their brains. Harley looks at the prisoner and says, "The people are copying us. We have to get them out of here." Back at the fight, Tungusta shouts that everyone needs to run. He can feel his essence exploding, and Zod punches through his helmet, telling him, "Zod will not die." Rick tells Enchantress to hurry up and get the teleport spell ready, and she says that she can't. Harley isn't here. Rick shouts, "Do it now!" And Enchantress says, "Fine. Hocus freaking pocus." Just as Tungusta explodes, Rick jumps in, grabbing Harley, shouting, "No one gets left behind!" And a little while later, after Tungusta explodes, the entire facility is destroyed. Zod, who's still on fire, tells everyone, "Zod gave you destruction." Harley watches on, saying, "Yeah, but the prisoners, they were all like us and they died." Katana holds her sword to Cosmonaut's neck and he says, "Nuts." Katana tells him, "Yeah, you can say that again." Back at Belrive, Harcourt heads to a helicopter and Ick reports that they've managed to capture one member of the Annihilation Brigade. Those others are presumed dead. However, among them, one codenamed Gulag was not present. Harcourt looks back, stating that she will never find Carla. And Amanda tells her not to worry about it. They're gonna find her soon enough, along with the people. Harcourt takes out her gun, telling her that she knows that she thinks that she is the one who killed Hack. But she doesn't know everything. As the trigger of the gun is pressed, all that can be heard is a click, and Amanda smiles. She tells Harcourt that she removed all but 4 bullets from her pistol this morning, and there was no brain bomb at the end of that self-destruct countdown. She figured while the team was out that she would do something stupid and sent out a message, which is why she was tracking where it went. Harcourt takes out the gun and hits Amanda with it, shouting, "You are the devil! Do you really want to know who killed Hack? It was!" But before she can say the name, a boomerang is thrown into the back of Harcourt's head. And Boomerang says that he just saved her life. Later, as Zod looks at the black vault, he tells them, "Soon, I will release all of you inside." He then looks at himself in a mirror, asking, "So you put a bomb of kryptonite in my head?" He blasts into the mirror with his heat vision, bouncing it off into his own skull, shouting, "Then Zod himself will cut it out!" A few moments pass, and the thunderous screams of Zod can be heard throughout Belrive, and Amanda shouts for them to blow Zod's brain now! But before the switch can be pressed, Zod tears into the room, tossing the implant towards Amanda, saying, "I believe the kryptonite was yours!" Amanda looks at it, telling him, "You cut it out of yourself, dear God!" Zod looks at everyone, telling them, "No. Not God, Zod!" He begins to burn everyone in the room as he destroys the place, and then something hits him in the head. He looks back with a boomerang sticking out of his own brain. And Boomerang tells him that he may want to get some antiseptic cream on that. And things are blowing me at the shits, which sounds worse than I meant it to. Croc stares out, telling him,
I see brain. I want to eat brains now.
Zod shouts, do you all know what the Black Vault truly is? It is a portal to the Phantom Zone itself. There is so much inside the Phantom Zone, the army of prisoners of Krypton. The army that once I've released will be under my command, and nothing can stop me now. Enchantress shouts, accept magic, and she fires a blast of energy, but Zod uses his heat vision, telling her to shut up! Your host is still human, and I could kill humans! He then shouts for everyone to behold the vengeful prisoners of Krypton's past. Suddenly, spirits begin to shoot out of the Black Vault, and Croc says that he can't eat ghosts! Zod calls out to Amanda, telling her, you have my thanks for giving birth to the new world. Nothing on this planet will. But before he can finish, Cosmonaut charges and slamming his head into Zod's back. He looks down at Zod and he tells him, nuts. And Zod picks himself back up, stating,
this planet is confusing, and Zod will give it order.
He begins to fire his heat blast in every direction, destroying everything, while the spirits continue their attack. And then from above, the roof begins to rip away, and the Eradicator, along with Cyborg Superman, arrive, telling Zod that they will obliterate all of those who stand against the Children of Krypton! Like, what is even going on now? Deadshot looks up and says, great, more insane killer Kryptonians. And Cyborg Superman calls out, we have come here for one thing and one thing only. And Boomerang asks, is it boomerangs? Amanda shouts that they've come for Zod. Zod slams down on the cosmonaut, screaming, Zod will do away with every unclean earthling on this godforsaken place. As Cyborg Superman and Eradicator float down, Cyborg Superman looks at the Black Vault and says that it's giving off impossible electromagnetic readings and gravitational waves. Zod tells them that this is his inheritance. It contains his heart, an army of Krypton who has been imprisoned inside of the Phantom Zone for far too long. And you, one of a robot and one of a mangled semi-human atrocity, what would you want from Zod? Amanda calls out to everyone that if Zod is right about an army of super criminals, they need to close the Black Vault, or so help her God, she'll kill them all herself. Boomerang says, geez, don't make it sound like an attractive offer. And Cyborg Superman grabs Zod by the shoulder, telling him, what you want matters. We have one goal, and that is destroying Superman. And that is an order. Zod shouts, I act as I choose, and I will free those that I choose, for I am their general. Zod punches through the Cyborg Superman's mechanical arm, telling him, you do not order your general. And one of the wraiths then grabs Boomerang, and he says, boomerangs don't hurt these things! I've checked! But with everyone fighting, Amanda Waller starts to move the debris around, asking, where did he throw it? Harley then helps Rick up, stating that he has a plan. Katana will slice through the hole into the vault, and they'll throw the kryptonite bomb inside of it. He's not an expert, but this is only brain-sized, so Rick figured that he would throw a few more grenades in with it to make the boom just a little bit bigger. Since he's already hurt, he'll be the one to deliver the bomb. Harley tells him, no, it'll kill you. And Amanda grabs the bomb and satchel, stating, no, she'll be the one to do it. This is her responsibility. Enchantress asks, is our despotic jailer confessing imperfection? And Boomerang says, yeah, the world is definitely ending. Everyone begins to focus their attacks on Zod, while Amanda, Rick, and Katana make their way to the Black Vault. Katana leaves the vault, slamming her katana in, and as the Black Vault begins to crack, it erupts, knocking her away. Amanda then starts to run towards the opening, stating that she's sorry that she let her kids down. And Rick hits her with an elbow and tells her, you can make it up to your kids later. Consider that payback for putting us in prison in the first place. Rick then picks up the satchel, jumping into the opening, telling everyone, screw it! It's called the Suicide Squad, right? Back outside, Zod knocks the Eradicator away, shouting, that is enough! I will free those of the Black Vault! And he flies over to the orb, but as he does, it begins to crack, and ka-thoom! It explodes. Everyone looks at the empty space, and Croc says that the Black Vault, it's... Zod finishes the sentence, telling everyone, gone. You have no idea what you've done. They are gone. I kneel. Cyborg Superman puts his hand on Zod's shoulder, telling him that they can give him what he wants. Only they can find a way back into the Phantom Zone. Zod gets up, stating, perhaps. An Eradicator asks, what of his quarrels with the humans? Zod walks over to Amanda, telling her, from one leader to another, you are a danger to your people. You will never truly know how close you came to destroying mankind. I have no doubt that you will someday succeed in doing so. As Zod and Cyborg leave, Boomerang asks Amanda, before we go back into solitary confinement, in gross violation of our constitutional rights, there's one thing that I would like to know. Since you got the one person who wasn't a complete psychopath killed, who's gonna lead Suicide Squad now? And there you have it, folks. This is actually a tie-in to a Superman story known as Black Dawn, I think it is. But anyway, that's where General Zod's going, and we're going to be covering that story very soon. And if it's not Black Dawn, then it's another one. Either way, it's a Superman story that is coming out very soon. And make sure that you subscribe to this channel so you can find out what happens with General Zod and what happens to the Suicide Squad. Who is going to be running it next? And don't forget, guys, I'm running for president in like 3 years. That's right, me, the comic historian, is going to run for president to tell you epic stories from the podium. All you need to do to be a part of my campaign is subscribe to my channel right now and follow me on Twitter. Comic historian! When's the next election, Dan? What? It's like 2020, right? 20, okay. Comic story in 2020. That's it. Peace, I'm out.